Swanson. We're here at Lynn's Propane Trucks. We've got another stock truck here for you today. This is a 2019 Freightliner. It's got a 34.99 gallon tank, Cummings ISL, 300 horsepower engine, Allison transmission, and then the rest of the truck, aluminum, stainless steel everywhere. It's an absolute gorgeous truck. We've got aluminum wheels. We have a polished aluminum fuel tank, stainless steel steps. We have vertical exhaust with a stainless cover, stainless grab handles, chrome bumper, chromed grille. We've got aluminum air horns with the snow shields on, bright finish, heated mirrors. Back deck, we've got stainless steel deck, stainless steel fenders, fender brackets, oversized stainless steel meter box. As you can see here as well, we've got strobes in the front headlights. We'll see the strobe on the back of the truck in a moment. But let's jump in the cab and we'll take a look at a few of the options. We've got the wood grain dash. Makes it look really nice. The Allison selector switch. And up above that, we've got our factory rocker lights, rocker switches for the work lights and the strobe lights. So the work lights, we've got two on the lower rear corners of the cab, and then there are two on the rear head of the tank. We'll take a closer look at those in a minute. And then the strobe lights, we just saw the ones that are in the headlight enclosures, but we also have one on the rear tank as well. Next to those rockers are the rear differential, driver-controlled rocker here. And then moving across, we've got power windows, power locks, heated mirrors. And these are the buttons for the manual regen, if you need that. Up above, we've got a top-of-the-line radio AM, FM, weather band, Bluetooth, MP3, USB, everything you could possibly need. Two 12-volt outlets, you know, you've got your GPSs, you're charging any in-cab electronics, phones, anything like that. This truck has a three-function remote, PTO, throttle, and e-stop. Really nice option. Your drivers use it. All they need to have is the emergency stop. But the PTO and throttle button, you haul the hose out to the customer's tank, hook it up, kick the PTO on, throttle up as the tank fills, take the throttle off, and shut the PTO off. It's a really nice function. Saves pump life. It's not running as long. But also, your drivers use it. So if the battery dies, they replace it so that they can use it on their next stop. When you just have a single function, it tends to live on the dash. Battery dies, you get pulled over by the DOT, your emergency shutdown doesn't work, and you get a hefty ticket. So it's worth a few dollars up front, and it's a really nice option for your drivers. In this truck, we also have a backup camera. You see mounted over here. We've got a color backup display monitor here. So we mounted here so that you can go from the display right to your mirrors on this side and your mirrors on the other side. It's really nice. It eliminates the blind spot directly behind the truck. It's a great safety feature. Typically, when customers get it the first time, they get it on all their following trucks. We've got a custom printer stand out here. They're all fabricated custom to each individual cab. So this is, it's nice and solid. It's not going to be rattling as you drive down the road. We also have a ticket holder here to help keep your driver organized. We see tickets spread all over the cab all the time. So anything we can do to help them keep organized is nice. Let's move to the side of the truck and we'll take a look at a few more things. Okay, so we have a little better look at a few of the options we talked about before. Stainless steel steps. I don't know if you've seen these steel steps, but within 3 or 4 months, they're rusted and brown and disgusting looking. Stainless steps is a really nice option, especially since you climb up and down and scuffing these up every single stop, 30, 40 times a day. We've got the polished aluminum fuel tank. We've got the aluminum cover on the DEF tank as well. Aluminum wheels. Stainless grab handle. The work hand lights on the back of the truck here. So we've got these two on the lower corners, and then we've got the two on the rear head of the tank. We call it stadium lighting because it lights up all around your truck when you turn these on, from both sides all the way to the back of the truck. All the workspace for your driver. So he steps out of the truck, it's ice and snowy. He can see where he's walking, where he's stepping. It's a really nice safety feature. Moving back, we've got a chalk block holder here, spring-loaded. So it's nice and easy to use, nice and easy to secure the load. Rubber in the front and the back so they're not rattling going down the road. Moving back, stainless fenders, stainless fender brackets, stainless fender spacer here. We do this because we set the mud flap back so you can't pin it between a snowbank and tear it off. Because we set it back, we've got to put a stainless spacer here to keep the road grind from blowing up on the rear deck. Rear deck, as you can see, stainless steel. A lot of the piping on the back of the truck here, stainless steel standard as well. Oversized meter box. let's move to the back and we'll take a closer look at these options. At the back of the deck here, first thing I want to touch on is one of the biggest features is the lower deck. Now, it's all stainless. That's a huge feature. It's lowered. That's a big thing. Everything's within your center of gravity, whether you're reeling in the reel, the meter, loading the truck. Most of the trucks you see, the chassis rails extend back behind the rear axle. You've got a prefabricated deck. The builders just throw it up there and bolt it on. That puts your deck up high. You're working up above your center of gravity all day long. This is your driver's office. This is where he does his work all day long. You want to make it as efficient as possible for him. You'll also notice, in conjunction with the lower deck, lower spills. Not just lowered, but angled at the correct angle. So you've got your 2-inch load line in the middle of winter. It's not flexible at all. I see a lot of guys with it up above their shoulder trying to line up the Acmes to thread them up. It's nice and easy. It's the right height, the right angle. Bring it right in under your shoulder, and it threads right on. Nice and simple for your drivers. Moving over here, we've got the oversized stainless meter box. Inside that, we've got an LC meter with an LCR2 electronic register, 2-stage preset standard. That means if you want to drop 286.9 gallons, it'll drop it right to the tenth every single time. We hose our hose end nozzle in the meter box. Keeps it clean and dry. Easy in, easy out. A lot of times you've got these threading onto an Acme on the deck. So every time you get there, you're unthreading it off the Acme. You get your delivery done, you're going to thread it back on. Not with this. You grab it, pull it out, drop it back in. Nice and simple. It's clean and dry every time you want to use it. We've got an oversized meter box here, so you can do any repairs on the meter you want to without removing the meter box. You see a lot of stuff come in here. You want to change, clean the strainer, do some maintenance to the meter. You've got to take the meter box off to get at it. With this, that's not the case. We've also got extra room in here as well, so we've got a shelf. You can put gloves, fittings, anything like that. On the side here, we've got a bottle holder. It's for leak check soap, but we see a lot of drivers using it for bee killer in the summer. Nice place to keep it nice and handy for them when they need it. Up top, we've got the two work lights. We talked about the two on the lower rear corners of the cab. We've got the two up here. They light up all around the truck at night. It makes for a really nice work environment. When your guys' hours of service are extended, they're working 10, 12-hour days. They're out late at night. It's a very nice safety feature. On the top there, we've got the camera for the backup camera. The monitor we saw in the cab mounted right on the cowl on the passenger side. So that eliminates the blind spot directly behind the truck. It's really nice. Below that is our strobe light, toggled in the cab there, and we've got the two in the front headlight enclosures as well. Below that's the third brake light, and then we've got the recessed float gauge. A lot of times you see these, they're mounted to the tank, not recessed into it. You've got a rain guard over it, and just rust running right down the tank. So one, you can't shear it off an accident, but two, you don't have the rust running down the back of the tank as well. Moving across here, we've got an NA rail. Polished aluminum is spec for 250 feet of 1-inch hose, comes standard with 150 feet of 1-inch low-temp hose. The reason we over-spec it is so that you have extra room in here. So it's spec for 250 feet, but if you get a reel, it's spec for 150. The only way you're going to fit 150 of 1-inch hose on there is if you reel it perfectly every time. Now, your guys are always hustling, trying to get as many deliveries as they can done. With this, you've got all the extra room you need. It's not going to be lopping over the side and getting pinched between the drum and the frame. It's not going to be rubbing up against the deck. You've got plenty of room to reel it in any way you want to, as quickly as you want to. This truck has a guide master on it. This is a very nice feature for guiding in the hose. If you don't have it, you're guiding it by hand, you're getting on your gloves or your bare hands, anything that you drag the hose out through on your way out and your way back in. So this is really nice. It's easier on the back as well. You just guide it into the reel. It's a very nice option. We've got the reel set up on some brackets here, so it sets the frame up off the deck. A lot of times we see these trucks come in with just dirt and leaves caked in there. They actually turn into soil, it seems like. With this, when you wash your truck, you can just blast it from the side and it blows everything out. It's easy to get clean. If you don't have it up off the deck, it's really tough to get that dirt and debris out of there. On the fill, we have here a disc. This disc is tied into the range inhibit function on the Allison transmission. So if you don't put this disc back on after loading, you can't put the truck in gear and pull away. excellent safety feature. This is the most common accident we see, so it's also the most common safety feature we put on these trucks. If we move to the side, we'll take a look at a few more options. Again, we've got the stainless fender spacers, stainless fenders, stainless fender brackets. We've got these nice little penny light line lights in there as well. Really nice. Moving forward, you'll see the stainless steps, the aluminum cover on the after treatment device, vertical exhaust with a stainless cover, stainless grab handle. Inside, you can't see it, but we've got an oversized PTO shaft, straight as an arrow. It takes a little more effort to get it that way, but it's worth it. We see a lot of these come in, and they're at obscene angles. Universal is working overtime. You replace them constantly because it's not true. It's not a straight line. With this, you've got less maintenance, and the parts are going to last a lot longer. Everything we do on the truck, we get diagrams that are color-coded. So the wire, pneumatics, anything like that. If you look in the frame rails, you see a yellow pneumatic line. You can look right at the diagram. It's color-coded. You can see what part and location it goes to in the back, what part number and location it goes to in the front. It makes troubleshooting and understanding what we've done really simple. This truck's built. It's ready to deliver gas. If you have any questions, give us a call at 800-252-5467. We'll talk to you soon.